Minuscule.
So you're saying there's non-disclosure agreements with the other ones?
The developers have forced us not to talk about what we want out of this. We've wanted some things beyond money. This is not about
okay.
money.
Okay. So when there's money, where does the money go?
The developers have forced us not to talk about what we want out of this. We've wanted some things beyond money. This is not about
okay.
money.
Okay. So when there's money, where does the money go?
It goes into community funds that already have. I know one fund has paid for one of the members at Union Market. Her car was almost totaled by a construction truck that took out her front bumper and the side of her car. Another construction truck hit the side of another resident's house. Okay, these are the sort of community protection funds that we have to fight to get, that we've asked at the Zoning Commission. It's not coming through that process. And so the only way we were able to get it is through the court. This is the sort of stuff that should be built into the plan to help protect communities undergoing dramatic development changes.
So what
dramatic.
I'm taking from the Adams Morgan Hotels, there was a couple $1 million that was deposited into a fund that then went out and purchased affordability in nearby buildings. That's what I heard you say.
We have to express our TOPA rights. We're putting down payments on buildings for TOPA rights with the TOPA rights. And you know, the question is, why are we doing this? This is something the Office of Planning should be taking
that,
on the front end.
In Union Market, there have been a couple of settlements. You can't disclose all of them, except one
yeah.
of them was $100,000 or $150,000.
Right.
And as far as I can tell from what you said, that went to replace some cars that were damaged by construction.
Councilmember Medicine, they're going into community funds that are 501c3s. They have to report all this every year.
Okay.
So that's all reported, public information. All of that is publicly available. The point is, the hundreds,
does that come back as a community,
the thousands of
does
hours.
Does that come back as a community amenity or just
no,
as repair?
No, that is we had to fight for that. A community amenity is something that you discuss and agree on before the process even unfolds like this. I mean, we've had to go to these courts to kind of just point out, hey, the comprehensive plan talks about anti-gentrification policies. The comprehensive plan right now speaks to environmental impacts, speaks to infrastructure impacts. It's superficial. They're not strong policies, but we've relied on them. We want the council to make these policies stronger. If the policies are stronger, then everybody at the start of this race at the Zoning Commission can understand, hey, when a developer is, you know, going from 40-foot building by right to 120 feet, all that extra air right value, a portion of that goes into funding Metro, funding a community fund to fight displacement, going into other